As part of the new Nordic Lexicon, students ask researchers to choose something that represents their work. Marta chose the sea and the book by Sylvia Earle, The World is Blue.
We are now at the seaside. When you look at the sea or when you hear the word ocean, what comes to your mind?
When I hear the word ocean, well, I always think about our blue planet, water in general, and of course the water cycle that connects us all. And this way of thinking has been greatly inspired by Dr. Sylvia Earle's book, The World is Blue, How Our Fate and the Oceans Are One. This is a wonderful book that changes our perception of the vast blue space, but also introduces us to the world's largest life supporting system that is largely unexplored, but threatened, unfortunately, by human activities.
What do oceans mean to you personally, but also professionally, because I know you're a researcher?
Well, as you know, I'm here in Denmark, in Aarhus, but I live in Gdynia, and I do my PhD research project at the University of Gdansk. So we have Poland and Denmark, two countries that are connected by the sea. And what's really important is that I always think about the Baltic Sea, this unique ecosystem that we are so happy to share. I always think about it as part of the global ocean, and it has so many different implications when it comes to our perception, when it comes to our education, but also our ways of relating to it. So that's basically it.
Interesting.
We're connecting to the ocean.
We definitely are. And tell me, has the book inspired you in some way in your own research?
Absolutely, absolutely. The most important thing is to conceptually reconnect to the global ocean in the context of the Baltic Sea region.
The Baltic Sea region can be defined in different ways. In 2023, the current members of the Council of the Baltic Sea States include Latvia, Lithuania, Estonia, all the Nordic countries, as well as Germany, Poland, and the European Union.
I study policy documents shaping the EU strategy for the Baltic Sea region. So the EU strategy for the Baltic Sea region is the EU's first macro-regional strategy. And it has three objectives: to save the sea, to connect the region, and to increase prosperity. And its main goal is to enhance cooperation among Baltic Sea states, NGOs, other institutions, and of course Baltic Sea residents. So I studied these documents, and I focus on how the Baltic Sea and its governance is represented in them. So such an approach helps me understand the impact of our language use, for example, metaphors, framings, or grammar structures, on our relation to the Baltic Sea and its marine governance. And what is also very important in the case of my research work is the fact that I also have a chance to suggest alternative ways of thinking about our Baltic Sea and the way we care for it, protect it, and manage it. So my thesis is based on a set of very simple questions like what is, why, what if, and how. So it not only does it expose some unsustainable stories we live by here in this region, but it also makes some practical recommendations, including ocean literacy.
Ocean literacy, what an interesting term. Could you explain a little bit what it means?
Absolutely, I will give you a short definition. It's our understanding of the ocean's influence on our lives and our influence on the ocean. It's also about our ability to communicate about this in a meaningful way, and of course about making inform choices and decisions on the basis of this knowledge.
Mm-hmm. Sounds great. Do you have some examples what it could mean to have good level of ocean literacy?
Well, this is, I would say, we can say it's a skill, but also it's a process and also a relation. So theoretically, we can work on it till the end of our lives. And this is what makes it so fascinating, because you can never say, now I'm ocean literate. This is something that I'm aiming for. It's really inspirational because, I mean, the concept of ocean literacy, because you can work on this as a researcher, you can educate people, you can inspire them, you can engage in different kinds of projects. For example, recently I've recorded a lecture on Baltic Sea beaches and the ecosystem services they provide. So it was really a great experience for me, so that I can actually put theory into practice.
If we wanted to get inspired here in our Baltic region by the rest of the world when it comes to ocean literacy and marine protection, where could we look?
Here in our region?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there are so many places, and I will give you two examples. The first one here in Denmark, for example, at Fjord and Veldt. It's a marine center that focuses on harbor purposes and their behavior and how we can protect them. Here in the Baltic Sea region. And also the Hel Marine Station of the University of Gdansk in Poland. On Hel Peninsula, we can find a seal rehabilitation center. So I would strongly recommend these two locations, but we can actually practice ocean literacy everywhere we are, even 1,000 kilometers or miles away from the shore.
Sounds beautiful. And
it,
tell me, if you wanted to leave us with an inspiring message, something that you would like everyone to remember about ocean literacy, what would it be?
I would give you a very inspirational quote from Dr. Sylvia Earle's book. She says that without the blue, there's no green, and that water is key to life. So probably that would be the message.
Perfect. I hope we all remember and practice ocean literacy in the future. Thank you very much for our meeting today.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure.